Good morning, ma'am.
Morning. You have the boat show done?
Yes, ma'am, right here.
Good. You know, this will be my first viewing of the boat show, and I really don't know what to expect. But I hear that you do some good spotlights on work centers.
Oh, we do, and we like to show what goes on behind the scenes here on the show. People like stuff like that.
Good, and the rest is educational, I suppose. You know, I hope you show some heritage, code of conduct, and being professional.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, come on, what the fuck?
Hat day! Yeah!
I got a pocket.
You disgusting f-
No plastic in the metal!
Good to hear. Does the episode at least kick off with a rousing rendition of Anchors Away or Battle Hymn of the Republic?
No, our theme song is a Zeppelin tune.
Huh? That's odd. Especially considering I probably can't name one of them.
Well, that's okay. I'm sure half the crew members on board can't either, which is why our show is considered educational. Sorry, ma'am. Anyway, enjoy the show.
I'll try. Welcome to episode 6 of the Iwo Jima Boat Show, where this time last year the word dukum wasn't in anyone's vocabulary. I'm MC Tuanucci.
And I'm MC Essam Ward. And tonight, as always, we have an educating and entertaining lineup for you. So let's check that rundown. Tonight, we kick off our mid-season premiere with a segment highlighting the hull technicians on board, courtesy of MC Essam Tucker.
Then, we highlight Marines and sailors of the 24th MEW as they set up a forward operating base off the coast of Djibouti and conduct sustainment training. Next up, MC1 Hevner hits the streets as he gets various answers from crew members on their favorite television show.
We'll follow that up with another Words with Wallum as he once again enhances our vocabulary. In our next segment, we'll bring another exciting episode of What the What, where we talk about the restricted maneuvering doctrine and what it means.
Finally, MC1 Hevner captures various crew members on film as they show how to shake off stress. You don't want to miss that. It all starts right now on the Iwo Jima Boat Show.
Every department works together aboard the USS Iwo Jima to ensure the mission to defend America's interests is met full force with the strength and fortitude only the Navy and Marine Corps team can provide. During deployments aboard one of the United States Navy's most versatile platforms, this amphibious assault ship and her crew morph into a warfighting machine capable of launching an attack on land, in the air, and at sea. It takes a well-trained crew to ensure the effectiveness of the USS Iwo Jima. This is their story, one shop at a time.
Hull maintenance technicians, or HTs, work diligently day in and day out to ensure that many of the ship's vital systems, from the pit to the bridge, run smoothly to maintain the excellence and mission readiness that this ship has come to provide.
Our job, fully entitled, is in between the plumbing, the welding services, sheet metal fabrication. Our big thing is the plumbing issues right now that are going around the boat, clogged toilets, clogged urinals. But a lot of people in the shop, you know, like to stay here, do the sheet metal side, you know, a little bit of the welding. You know, we can do a lot of welding inside the shop, and we can do, you know, trouble calls outside, and, you know, we take welding gear to a location, do a weld job, studs, you know, fabricate stuff for the pit, you know, all over the ship.
HTs, while serving a critical role aboard the ship, may often find it difficult to push through a rough day or a tough job, but they still manage to find ways to keep their days bright and their spirits light.
It helps being able to work with such good people. So being able to laugh and make jokes and not take it personal. Like, it's good to work in a shop where you get along with the others. So yeah, it's a crappy job, but it's not as bad as people think it is because we have fun with each other.
Reporting from USS Iwo Jima, this is Mass Communication Specialist Seaman Shelby Tucker.
Marines and sailors with the 24th Marine Expeditionary Unit stopped in Djibouti this past month to conduct sustainment training. Marines and sailors built an operating base and conducted a wide variety of training events to include HST lifts, demolition ranges, and live fire exercises. Training ensured the 24th MU remains America's premier crisis response force.
So on this episode of The Boat Show, I like to put emphasis on the fact that technology has come a long way. Back in the 70s when personal computers came about, it took machines as big as this hangar bay to make 2 terabytes of memory. Now you can fit it in the palm of your hand, which compels a lot of people to record their favorite TV shows and put them on these external devices. So it compels me to ask people, what is their favorite TV show of all time? Let's go find out. Hey, I got a question.
Yes.
Hey. As he tries to shy away from me, I saw that he's like, Do you have a favorite TV show?
Oh, I like The Dance. So the shows about the distinction between the plastic and plastic and metal.
Who's that?
It was a show done by Chief.
He's talking about The Boat Show. Okay, so The Boat Show is your favorite TV show?
Yeah, I like it.
Wow, hey, now that's a shameless plug for you. That's kind of cool. I did not script that at all. I did not slip him a $5 bill. It was totally unscripted. Wow. Ooh. Wow, that just made my day. I see some other candidates over here. Hi, how you doing? As they always shy away from me. I don't know, they get so scared. But Quackenbush, he's a smooth customer. He ain't gonna run away, because he's cool like that. What is your favorite all-time TV show?
Sons of Anarchy.
Sons of Anarchy? Why is that?
I don't know, it's just entertaining, I guess.
Good show, huh? A lot of good writing?
Yeah.
Good character development?
Yeah.
Who's your favorite character on the show?
Probably Jax.
And why is that?
Main character, I guess.
Okay, fair enough. So, you seen all the episodes?
None of the new seasons.
Oh, none of the new seasons? Okay. Well, of course, being on deployment, it's kind of hard to. But that'll be one of the first things you do when you get back, right?
Yeah, probably.
Well, let's get some people here in the I-10 P-Way. Look at this! They scattered! What is this all about? It's like you turn the light on and they scatter like cockroaches. It's unbelievable. It breaks my heart that nobody wants to be on TV. I'm asking people around the ship, what's their favorite all-time TV show?
Ooh, probably Big Bang Theory.
Big Bang Theory, that's a good one. Who's your favorite character?
Oh, it's probably gonna be Leonard. Always in between Sheldon and Penny, you know?
Well, so why is Leonard your favorite character?
Because he just gets it from everybody. He gets some sort of crap from everybody.
Including his girlfriend, too, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, fair enough. So that's your favorite all-time, huh?
Yep.
Do you have all the episodes on, like, an external hard drive or whatever?
I did at one point, yes, and then I finished them, so I deleted it.
Okay. But you don't rewatch them and all that?
No.
It's just, like, one-time-only thing, and it's like, okay, I'm over it.
Well, I mean, you can only watch the same thing enough times, you know, before it gets boring.
Okay, true. Fair enough. So, hey, we got a good one. See, they all say no. They might as well just throw a cross up and say, you're evil. How you doing, Mr. Davis?
How are you?
I'm doing fine, Corporal Davis. So I have a question. So I'm going around trying to get some answers on what people's favorite all-time TV shows are.
That 70s Show. It's gonna be this.
That 70s Show. Okay, so why that show?
Well, I'm from Wisconsin, and then it's based in Wisconsin.
Hello, Wisconsin! So who's your favorite character on that show?
I would have to say the I can't remember his name.
The yeah, I know you're talking about. Played by Walter Valderrama. Fez. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, he's.
So why is Fez your favorite character?
Well, I mean, he's funny. I mean, he does a lot of funny stuff. I haven't watched it in a while, but when I remember watching it, it's just, he's a funny guy.
All right, so let's get another Marine here. Hey, how you doing?
Hey, good, how are you?
Hey, doing fine. I like that accent. I can tell you're from Massachusetts.
No, Australia.
Oh, boy, that was way off on that one. You kind of had a New England accent.
People say I'm from Boston because I say car keys, but yeah.
Hi, the car and have a yard. I'm asking people what their favorite all-time TV show is. Do you have one in the States, or would it be from down under?
My favorite old-time TV show would definitely be Stargate.
Okay, Stargate, all right. And the cameraman agrees. He's shaking his head. He likes that. So why Stargate?
It makes the Air Force look absolute badass. Okay. And it's incredible teamwork, like amazing teamwork. And, of course, the sci-fi is really fantastic. So.
Okay, so what's your favorite character on that show?
Colonel Jack O'Neill.
Why is that?
Because he's really quick. He's really, really funny, like all the time. Even like the worst situation where his life's he's about to kill him, he cracks a joke. Awesome. It's hilarious.
Well, it's kind of awesome to see an Australian as a Marine. That's pretty cool. So are you a dual citizen?
Quadruple citizenship.
Quadruple? Holy moly. So you fly four flags. Who's the other countries?
All right, well, I was born in New Zealand, so New Zealander. I received citizenship in Australia after 5 years. So. My dad's Brazilian and my mother's American, so that's four.
Wow, that's impressive. We're kind of going off tangent here, but I was just kind of curious about, you know, his background. Okay, have a good day.
You too.
Okay, here we go. Let's see if they all avoid me. They all avoid me today. I don't get it. It's just the funniest thing. I'm going around asking people their favorite all-time TV show. What would yours be?
That 70s Show.
That 70s, okay, so it looks like That 70s Show is probably going to be like winning the race here because somebody else voted for that. So why do you like that show?
Just because it's like kids going through high school. You know, like people can relate to it easily. You know, they do, you know, they drink, they smoke, they get in trouble. But I mean, they're all pretty much good kids. Like, they don't mean any harm by what they do. They're just having fun in high school.
Well, that's a good answer. I can agree with that. So who's your favorite character?
Probably Eric, just because like he's the nerdy one. And he's like trying really hard to not be socially awkward. And in the end, it really works out for him.
Blue jacket board. Okay, cool. Well, let's say they're in the zone, so I'm not gonna break their concentration. And of course, somebody else runs away from me. So thanks, OS3 Phillips. It was going to be quick and painless. Which one would you probably give your all-time proverbial trophy to?
Probably have to go with Family Guy.
Family Guy? Okay, so why Family Guy?
I watched it every night before I went to bed.
Okay, who's your favorite character on Family Guy?
I have to say probably Brian.
Why is that?
I don't know. He just makes a show, I feel like.
He's one of those charismatic, sarcastic type of characters that people love and all that, right?
Yep, he's the important character in the show, I feel like.
Did you see last season? Any episode from last season?
When they kill a dog? Or when they kill Brian?
Yeah, that was pretty sad, wasn't it?
Yeah, they brought him back, though. So.
I got a little choky when I have to admit, I did get a little choky when Brian got ran over. All right, so all good answers. Looks like That 70s Show got two votes, so I guess for this little man on the street thing, I guess they kind of get the bragging rights in that case. A lot of good answers, and there's a lot of TV watchers out there.
And now it's time for Words with Wallum.
Almost didn't see you there. Good evening, and welcome to another episode of Words with Wallum. I'm your host, MCS and Wallum. I'm here to expand your vernacular horizons. Might just save your life one day. Today's word is dystopia. It's a noun originating from the late 18th century, meaning imaginary place or state in which everything is unpleasant or as bad as it can be, typically a totalitarian government or an environmentally degraded one. It's the opposite of utopia.
Man, that would suck to live in such a dystopian society.
This has been Words with Wallum. Thanks for stopping by.
Who can take a sunrise?
Who can take a sunrise?
Sprinkle it with you.
Sprinkle it with you.
Cover it with chocolate and a miracle to the Candyman.
The Candyman.
Ooh, the Candyman can.
So you have any dip?
Hell no.
I was just kidding. I don't do that nasty.
Candyman can, cause he mixes it with love and makes the world taste good.
Makes the world taste good.
Who can take a rainbow?
Who can take a rainbow?
Wrap it in a sigh.
Wrap it in a sigh.
Soak it in the sun and make a groovy lemon pie. The Candyman.
The Candyman.
The Candyman can. The Candyman can, cause he mixes it with love and makes the world taste good.
Makes the world taste good.
Wacky inflatable arm flailing tube man! Wacky inflatable arm flailing tube man! Wacky inflatable arm flailing tube man! Wacky inflatable arm flailing tube man!
Hi there! I'm Ed Harris.
Set the restricted maneuvering doctrine. Set the restricted maneuvering doctrine.
That's not what it means. The restricted maneuvering doctrine is set when the watchstanders in the propulsion plant need to deviate from standard safety procedures to maintain maneuverability of the ship until it can be steered to a safe location. Typically, it is set during situations like underway replenishments, entering or leaving port, and when the ship is in restricted waters.
Restricted maneuvering doctrine, set.
Another episode of the Iwo Jima Boat Show. On our next episode, MC1 Abbott and MC1 Hevner will check out an area of the Iwo Jima that's been known to be haunted. You don't want to miss that.
Until then, we'll see you out about shit. Good night.
Yeah.